cautionary tale from our Victorian history. Mr. Baxter, a respected pioneer of industry. He made the most of the divisions in a class society, aligned his pockets by exploiting those in need. But still no amount of profit could his appetite exceed. He was endowed with the opinion that the poorest of the poor was simply fodder for the cannon, common stock and nothing more. He would further speculate it was his duty to ensure they remain exactly where they're meant to be. Because an ally of complete control is abject poverty. Oh, Mr. Baxter, you're not so clever after all. Don't you know that after pride will come a fall? Mr. Baxter lured his workers from the slums of London town. He promised bed and board and wages every week of half a crown. But the board was dirty water and the bed the stony ground. Then to add more insult to the injury, he said, I'll charge them more in rent than wages, so they'll end up owing me. And as his conscience died a death, the more he hardened like a stone. His heart became a withered garden, choked with weeds and overgrown. How he despised their sallow faces and their frames of skin and bone. So with no provocation other than disdain, he would beat them black and blue from here to there and back again. Oh, Mr. Baxter, if you go treating them this way, pretty soon you will discover every dog will have his day. Oh, Mr. Baxter, you're not so clever after all. Don't you know that after pride will come a fall? At its worst, the unspeakable was spoken, the unthinkable occurred. They never did find Baxter's body, but the constables concurred. They had all the evidence they'd ever need. They found the last of Mr. Baxter lodged between the workers' teeth. So the moral of this tale is plain for everyone to see. Baxter's story's an example of poor business strategy. Because your workers are your backbone, so don't fight the hand that feeds. Don't let your avarice dictate the things you do. Because your appetite may very well end up consuming you. Oh, Mr. Baxter, you paid a heavy price, it's true. Because the tables turned and all your dirty deeds came back on you. Mr. Baxter, you're not so clever after all. Don't you know that after pride will come a fall? The rise and fall of Mr. Baxter.
To the airport now. My time in Switzerland has sadly come to an end, but I'm not really that sad because I'm back in the summer, which is going to be brilliant. We've had a really, really great time, and you know, we're all really excited about what the future holds for us now as a band and as a production team. You know, it's going to be great. We had a good time, Reto.
Very good time. I'm very happy it's coming back to Switzerland.
Yeah.
I'm back here. Yes.
So thank you, Switzerland. Thanks for all the laughs, all the beers, all the friendship. and everything that you've had to offer. It's been brilliant. See you soon. See you back in the UK.
Reto Spörli on drums, everyone.